Today being day 61 of 100 days of prayer, our emphasis comes from the book of Matthew. I remember I had stated in the previous days, this week we'll be looking generally at the Beatitudes of Jesus Christ from the book of Matthew 5. And yesterday we looked at Matthew 5 verse 3. Matthew 5 verse 4. Today we are looking at the book of Matthew 5 verse 6. Matthew 5 verse 6. And our title for today is A Righteous Diet. Yeah? A Righteous Diet. Before we read this Bible verse and also expound on it and also share with this righteous diet together, shall we have a word of prayer. Our kind and loving Master in heaven, we come before thy throne of grace today. We thank you for your grace and mercies, you have bestowed upon our lives. We want to invoke thy holy presence to abide with us, so that Jehovah God, you will interpret the word that we are about to do. And also, Jehovah God, you will be able to intercede for us on our behalf, and you will be able even further to try and to put our prayers in the right position, so that Jehovah God, you will hear us and you will answer our prayers. Today I pray for my dear viewer as we go through this. May you bless him or her, and may you, Father, draw him closer and closer to you. As in Christ Jesus, we have prayed and given thanks. A righteous diet. I know that food is something that is loved by many. And food is something that we cannot live without. I know people have stated in funny ways and have stated about food in different ways. Some have said that we live to eat, and others say that we eat to live. I don't know what is your view, but I want to bring this into perspective. Food is very important. And as you have heard, even through this pandemic, people have been asked to support those who do not have food, to give food to the poor, to the neighbors, and also to share whatever they have. And indeed, it's a blessing if you share what you have with your neighbor. And if you give someone food, I know it's very easy for that person to love you. It's very easy for that person to accept you. It's very easy for that person to be friends with you. Food is something good. But today we want to speak of something else. A righteous diet. And remember, even the world, the doctors are advising us that we should mind our diet. We should take diet which is good for our lives. We should have diet which is will cultivate health in our bodies. We should avoid diet that is full of this, full of that. We should avoid diet that will make us add weight. Or if you are very slim, then you are advised to eat such kind of diet so that you can gain weight. If you want to grow your muscles, you are told eat this kind of diet so that your muscles will be strengthened. So diet is something good. But today we want to speak about blessed diet. Yeah? And the Bible in the book of Matthew 5 verse 6, we read Matthew 5 verse 6, the Bible says that blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled, or they shall be satisfied. Righteousness is holiness, likeness to God, and God is love. You know, righteousness is holiness and likeness to God. Who is this God? And what character does this God have? Is love. God is love. You can read that in the book of 1 John 4 verse 16. Therefore, the hunger of righteousness is the healthy diet. It is the righteous diet that we are speaking about this. Hungering for to become like God. It is conformity to the law of God. For all thy commandments are righteousness. That is from the book of Psalms 119, verse 172. It says that conformity to the law of God is lusciousness, and this is the hunger that we should have. This is the diet that we should look forward to feed on. And love is the fulfilling of the law. Yeah? If you want to be like God, you want to please God, you must have love in your heart. And to have love in your heart, you must fulfill the law. Romans 13:10. Righteousness is the love, and love is the life, and life is of God. Righteousness is love, and love is life, and the life of God. The righteousness of God is embodied in Christ. We receive righteousness by receiving Christ. Well, if you are hungering for righteousness, if you are hungering to become like God, if you are hungering to be like God, we must be like Him, and we must ask Jesus to be in our hearts. Let me ask you today, and let me bring this to your attention. I want you to search in your heart, because to remember, this week we are looking at a time of heart searching, soul searching. Do you hunger and thirst for Christ's righteousness? Do you? His life of perfect selfless love and the substitutional death provides you with a twofold gift of justifying grace. The first of these is His imputed righteousness. When we speak about the imputed righteousness, this is the promise that you are covered by His perfect life through faith in that promise. Even if we sin, even if we are sinners, imputed righteousness is when you accept Him and He covers you through faith in that promise. That you believe that He died for you, you believe that He came to you. And imputed righteousness is when, through faith, you accept that. And when you accept Him, you are covered and you have that righteousness. The second aspect is His imparted righteousness. His imparted righteousness is, this is which is the promise that He will transform you from a being of selfishness into a being that reflects the selfless love of Jesus through living faith in that promise. We must accept Jesus in our heart. We must allow Him in our heart so that He can transform us from the being of selfishness. Because as we are created, the carnal nature of our bodies is to incline to sinfulness. It is to incline in doing the wrong thing. It is to incline in self-love and selfishness. But when we accept Jesus, He transforms us, and we become different, and we have that promise, and through that promise we are transformed, not to love ourselves, but to love His grace. This twofold gift will fulfill you. It will truly satisfy you, the gift of imputed righteousness and imparted righteousness. It will satisfy you. It will save you. Why not accept it today and start living a happy and Jesus-filled life in the awareness of His amazing reality of God's redemptive love? God loves you. God loves you. He wants you to be like Him. He wants you to get the righteousness that He has. And remember, in heaven, there is no unrighteous man will step into those in heaven. And there is no unrighteous man who will join the saints when the saints will be marching on. And when the Lord will be called up yonder, there is no unrighteous name of a person whose name will be found in the book of life. Therefore, today, as we pray, let us pray for Christ's righteousness to cover and fill us. Let us pray for that. Because without that, we will not be able to see heaven. Dear brethren, it is a high time that I invite you today to join me as we seek for this promise, the promise of God's righteousness. And indeed, God will be with us, and God will help us to have the righteousness that He has promised us. And when we have that righteousness, when He comes the second time, we will be part of the saints. And we'll be rejoicing to go to that city which is in heaven, which God promised us. And Jesus says that let not your heart be troubled. In his Father's house, there are many mansions. There are mansions which are enough for each and every one of us. And there are things that we cannot imagine. Mind cannot even fathom. Those things are kept for you and for me. Let us seek for this righteousness. Let us hunger for this. That is the righteous diet. The diet of righteousness. The diet to become like Christ. The urge and the motivation to be like Him will draw us closer and closer to Him. Shall we pray? Our kind and loving Master in heaven, we thank you for these words that you have given unto us. Indeed, we are in need of that wonderful diet, the diet of righteousness, the diet of becoming like you. Help us to hunger for that. Help us to hunger so that we can have the urge of becoming like you in our lives. And may thy love, the love that you showed us at Calvary, push us and motivate us to be like you. We call upon your Holy Spirit to abide with us. We call upon your Holy Spirit to direct us in the paths of truth. So that Jehovah God, we will do what is in accordance with thy will. And we will draw closer and closer to you. We pray that may you mold us. May you create us new hearts. So that Jehovah God, we will have a place for you in our hearts. We will live in accordance to thy will. Jehovah God, glory and honor shall be back unto thee because of our life. Commit my dear viewer into thy bosom. May you remember him or her. The difficult situations that he is passing through, he may be passing through, remember him and save him. The things that are disturbing his heart, Jehovah God, may you remove them. And as he brings them to Calvary, because burdens are lifted at Calvary, I know you are faithful and you get rid of these things. Thank you for this, Father, that you have brought us as a country, as a church. We pray that may you continue being with us. Even this, amid this COVID-19 pandemic, Jehovah God, you are still on your throne. And I know you are in control of everything. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, love of Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen and amen. Thank you. May God bless you. Continue sharing, subscribe, and remember to stay safe.